It's a beautiful day in the Niagara region. We're with my good friend Joe Capone.
Hello.
I'm Frank Mazzuca, Family Style, and we're at the Colaneri Estate Winery in the Niagara region of beautiful Ontario. We're blessed to have this kind of an Italian feeling culture of wineries in good old Ontario.
You know what? We're blessed because we come here, we've been coming here for so many years, and each year we pick a different winery to attend, and this particular year we've got a very unique blend of decor here from the Italian region, and it's absolutely beautiful on a beautiful day like this.
Saul's picked another winner.
Absolutely.
You know,
absolutely.
It's wonderful to have these beautiful guidebooks that take us through the Niagara region. Stella always tends to pick up all the jewels, and we are at the Colaneri Estate Winery in Niagara. And so they got a great looking place, like you mentioned, Joe.
Absolutely.
Great scenery in terms of the winery and how it faces the front of the beautiful Tuscan-inspired village. And we picked up a Cortopasso VQA from Colaneri, and we're going to enjoy that with our lunch. Now, did someone say lunch? Yeah, we talked about Tuscany, we talked about lunch.
What?
But let's see, and it's always a surprise, isn't it, Joe? It's always a surprise.
You know, we are so blessed because every year we come, the Mazzuca spoil us. Elaine and I are spoiled every year with a unique lunch, something different every year, and very tasteful every single year.
So let's try it out this year. So let's come a little closer. This year, we decided to focus on Tuscan bread and create this beautiful 12-layer muffaletta.
That's amazing.
It's we're dealing with a beautiful muffaletta spread, which is made with capers, olives, pickled celery, carrots, cauliflower, and then we've layered it with provolone, calabrese salami, capicola, sweet capicola, roasted herb turkey from Tuscany, a Tuscan-inspired roasted turkey with rosemary. We've got tomato slices with fresh calabrese oregano, beautiful basil leaves draped on top of that tomato, on top of lettuce, and then more muffaletta spread, and more provolone, and more Italian-inspired coca. So let's take a look at how it looks when we cut it through.
Wow,
so check this
beautiful.
Out. So I'm gonna do a little sample slice through, and to show you sort of the inspiration of all those layers. I mean, look at that. You can see all those layers we talked about. Joe, take a peek. See that?
It's
like a geography project. So that's what we're gonna do. And we're gonna cut those muffaletta slices in manageable bars.
They're not gonna last very long.
They're not gonna last very long.
Yeah.
And there's that nice roasted pepper and olive that's one of the key components of a beautiful muffaletta spread with the olives and capers. The muffaletta spread was invented by an Italian immigrant, American immigrant. And he needed something, I think he imported olives at one point, and at the bottom of the barrels, speaking of the barrels, were all these fragments of olives. And these olives, he decided to use them up, because they're bits and little pieces.
Yeah, yeah.
And then he used that to keep the bread moist, and you see how moist that bread is, right?
So very tender.
Yeah, so we're gonna cut those into manageable slices, and that's gonna be our muffaletta sandwich. And we're gonna plate that in a second. Back to a little Tuscany, we are have a beautiful arrangement of nice artisan tomato bocconcini cheese kebabs, and that's going to be a nice little accompaniment for our salad. The salad is a beautiful dinosaur lacinant kale salad. We're going to do a nice little poppy seed dressing, and we've got some to bring some nature back to the elements. Talk about culinary wineries tend to want to dry their grapes, and a lot of their estate wines are done with grapes that are dried for about 6 weeks.
Six weeks.
So to play up on that, we've got some dried cranberries to celebrate that culinary estate winery practice in maturing their grapes to a certain level, and that's what makes their wine so great. We're going to try their wine soon. We're going to mix that salad up.
We need to hurry because it's mouthwatering.
So we're going to mix that salad up. And again, it's kale, it's cabbage, and I'm making a mess on this barrel. And
what better way to top this whole lunch with a nice bottle of culinary wine right here?
Oh, we're gonna have a great time. So we're going to go old school and see. We grab an eco-friendly plate. And can you imagine now, if we just grab a muffaletta slab like that, you can see that beautiful pepper coming through. Look at those layers. Let's get a close up of all those layers. The flies want to get those layers too. Look, you got the beautiful Tuscan bread. You got all that muffaletta spread. You got the cheese and tomatoes and the Italian cold cuts, the basil.
Wonderful.
They want to lace that with a beautiful amount of salad here. And then everyone gets a kebab here. And that's how we do it. I mean, it doesn't take too much. Prepare the sandwich in advance. Get on the road. Fight the QEW traffic.
And come down. And this is what's waiting for you. And this is what I'm saying. We're beautiful. Spoiled every year.
And I want to thank Culinary Wineries for allowing us to use their...
Fabulous.
Chris Culinary for allowing us to use his barrel.
Fabulous.
And who's hungry?
We're all hungry.
We got to eat.
That's it.
So...
Bon appetit.
Hey, this is almost like the Greedy Italians. I watch that show of Greedy Italians, but we're not Greedy Italians. We're hungry Italians.
Exactly.
Bon appetit.
Thank you.
Muffaletta sandwich.
Well, you know what? It's something different. It's something very tasteful, and I'm always open to trying new things. So whenever we're with the Mazzucas, we're always experiencing new things.
New experience, new
Absolutely.
Food experience. What is it all about? And we're in Ontario, and we've got the world at our shoulders. Look at this beautiful vineyard here at Glenari State Winery, and let's go check out how our harvest is doing.
Absolutely.
See you again. Thank you.